What's going on, everyone? Welcome back. Today is September 24th, Friday. Happy Friday. On this post, I'll be talking about Cardano. I'll be giving a technical analysis on Cardano and see what could be going on. Before going into Cardano, of course, I'll be talking about Bitcoin because Bitcoin does affect the rest of the crypto markets and, of course, a lot of the altcoins. So I'm not going to be ignoring Bitcoin at all, even if I am going into a specific altcoin. Now, before I begin today, please do read my full disclaimer below. I am not a financial advisor, and none of this should be taken as financial advice. I am purely sharing with you guys my speculation and opinions on this market. You should always do your own due diligence before trading or investing in this market. Take responsibility for your own money because it is extremely risky and volatile in this market. Now, I do not own any Bitcoin at this time, nor do I own any Cardano, but I am open to trading them given a good setup. I do have quite a bit of the altcoins myself, but not Bitcoin or Cardano at the time of this video. Now, if you guys do want to support me and my channel, you guys can use any of my affiliate links in the video description section below. I do have affiliate links to crypto.com, Webull, and TradingView. You guys could get a bonus signing up for any of those websites or apps. And I should most likely get a bonus as well if you guys sign up using my affiliate link. So I would truly appreciate that. With that said, let's go ahead and dive right into the market. Let's see what has gone on since yesterday. Now, Bitcoin has had a dump within the past 24 hours. We're going to be taking a look into that. On the 4-hour time frame has been my focus before, which I did say there was a falling wedge pattern, which is generally a bullish pattern. Since yesterday, or within the past 24 hours, since we did get that dump from about 45K down to about 41K, I also see a falling wedge pattern zooming out onto a bigger time frame, which is the 12-hour time frame. Price action is getting support from the 12-hour 200 SMA, which is the orange line right here now. Now, I also do see another generally bullish pattern here, which is a double bottom pattern that is very noticeable on the 12-hour time frame. If price action does break out of this double bottom pattern, which would have a measured move that would take the price action out of this falling wedge pattern, that would look pretty good for the crypto markets. But until then, I'll be keeping a very close eye out on what Bitcoin could be doing. There's quite a bit of overhead resistance on top of the price action right now, including the daily moving averages, the 21, 50, 200, all above the price action right now, the 3-day moving averages, the 3-day 21 SMA, potentially the 3-day 50 SMA here, if the price action does not get a close on top of the 3-day 50 SMA within about 4 hours. The main moving averages I am keeping an eye out on would be the weekly 21 SMA, which price action is basically right above right now, and the weekly 50 SMA, which I'll get to in just 1 second. But my opinion on the market still, as of right now, is still bullish. Because I've been mentioning this on the monthly time frame RSI from the past cycles, the bull cycles from the past, we've had 2 big waves, okay? And so far for this bull cycle, we've only had 1 wave. It looks like until this month, price action could be rebounding here on the monthly RSI. However, September is still not done yet, even though it does look like a pullback here on the RSI. But if I am expecting the price action to play out on this monthly time frame like it did for the past 2 bull cycles here, then I could expect another wave. What could potentially change my opinion would be if price action starts closing below some of these weekly moving averages. I think in my opinion there, the probability of this bull cycle continuing may be diminishing. That, and I may not want to spend time seeing price action trying to break back on top of these weekly moving averages, or could even go lower. So I am going to be very cautious and see where this weekly candle or the future weekly candles close relative to the weekly moving averages. Let's go over to Bitcoin dominance. Currently about 41.5% almost. On the weekly time frame here, there is a double bottom pattern with bullish divergence. Double bottom patterns, generally bullish patterns. And now we do have bullish divergence here. Actually, we've had for about 2 weeks now. Let's see if Bitcoin dominance can actually continue to go lower. That would be better for the altcoins, assuming that Bitcoin does not dump. So if Bitcoin dominance continues lower, that would be further confirmation for me that altcoins are going to be going higher. Let's go over to given that Bitcoin price action does not dump. Let me add that. Let's go over to total altcoin market cap, total 3, which excludes Ethereum. I want to look at the altcoins without Ethereum because Ethereum is such a big part of the market. Could be forming a cup and handle pattern here, which is generally a bullish pattern, right? Or an ascending triangle pattern, both of which are pretty similar. So this is the next chart I'm watching for guidance on most of the altcoin markets. Now let's go into ADA. ADA here, on the weekly time frame, price action did break higher as the past couple of weeks. However, there was bearish divergence on this weekly time frame. Now the pullback here, if we actually go into the lower time frames, such as the daily, I see that price action is being rejected by the daily 21 and the daily 50 SMA. It is trying to break back on top of the 3-day 21 SMA. And price action did get very close to the weekly 21 SMA. The weekly 21 SMA here. Now, there is not a specific pattern I can come to a conclusion on, but it does look like it could be forming a falling wedge pattern, but I am missing that third touch on this bottom trend line here. Now, if price action can actually break above this top trend line, that could be a good signal that price action could be breaking out of this downtrend here. It could be continuing upwards, but there could be resistance at about that $3 level as we have seen in the past. So that is what I'm looking at for Cardano here. Of course, the possibility of a downside cannot be ruled out because the price action could still be continuing, could be actually bouncing off within this pattern, this potential pattern. So that's what I'm looking at. If price action breaks out of this top trend line, I think that would be a pretty bullish move. But if it does not, it could continue down to the sketch of this falling wedge pattern, which could potentially take us to the weekly 21 SMA here, currently about slightly just right underneath $1.90. So that could be a pretty big drop here for Cardano. That's something I'm looking out for. However, if we actually do take a look into some of the smaller time frames here, such as the 12-hour, there is bullish divergence on the 12-hour time frame. Let's see if price action can first break back on top of this 12-hour 21 SMA before potentially breaking out of this pattern. But if it does not break out of the pattern, it could come back to this bottom trend line, which is very close to or at the weekly 21 SMA. So that's something to be looking out for. Now, this would be my very short update on the markets, including Bitcoin, a lot of the altcoins, and Cardano. Let me know if you guys found this helpful. Give me a thumbs up if you guys did. I'll see you guys in the next video.